Now please practice with me. These are all the pronouns which we use when we are using them at the beginning of a sentence. Okay? So wherever subject is used, subject is a part of grammar. Again, you read more grammar, you'll come to it. Not necessary for us to know, but still it is important that we remember the pronoun which is used. Very important is which pronoun in the present tense only. Verbs we will also do tomorrow. In the present tense only, the third person pronoun has S. So, S addition is called singular verb. S addition is called plural noun. When you add S to a noun, it becomes plural. That means more than one. If you add S to a verb, that means it becomes singular one. Remove S, it becomes more than one. That is the idea which we have. So, here are all the pronouns. These are all used for subject. They are called first, second and third person. First person when the speaker is referring. Second person to whoever is speaking. And third person to somebody else outside or some topic which is being discussed. If we are talking about somebody, that person becomes third person. So please read after me. Read with correct pronunciation. Those who are interested in pronunciation, please observe how the pronunciation is made. Okay? That is most important. Unless you pronounce correctly, your English doesn't sound like English. No pronouncing dictionary can make your English better. You have to do only with practice. So please read. I like mangoes. We like mangoes. You like mangoes. Now you can be used for singular and plural. If I talk to one person, I'll say you. If I talk to all of you, I will say you. No two forms are there. He likes mangoes. Do you see the change now? Like became likes. This is a very important change. Everybody makes mistakes in the use of this. This happens only in present tense. It does not happen in past tense or any other tense. Only in present tense, this addition of S for he and she. So remember, she likes mangoes.
She likes mangoes.
They like mangoes.
They like mangoes.
I go to college.
I go to college.
We go to college.
We go to college.
You go to college.
You go to college.
He goes to college.
He goes to college.
She goes to college.
She goes to college.
They go to college.
They go to college.
Unlike he and she, which have gender, they has no gender. They can be used for combined boys, girls, only boys, only men, only women. No gender differentiation. Only I has no gender differentiation. Men can say I, women can say I. So, like that we find that the only difference is he, she, gender is different. He, she, verb is different. So many things. Now, if you make a list of 1000 verbs or 100 verbs or 500 verbs, now make sentences like this. Using pronoun, make sentences with all those verbs, present tense only, you will never make a mistake again. Otherwise, often you say, I like, I go, correct English. He like, he go, wrong English. So that mistake, it's a simple mistake, but it is a very, very important mistake. Let's read again. I play cricket.
I play cricket.
We play cricket.
We play cricket.
You play cricket.
You play cricket.
He plays cricket.
He plays cricket.
She plays cricket.
She plays cricket.
They play cricket.
They play cricket.
I learn English.
I learn English.
The word is pronounced as learn.
Learn.
Learn. It is not learner. Okay? It's learn.
Learn.
Did you understand? Okay, so please read again. I learn English.
I learn English.
We learn English.
We learn English.
You learn English.
You learn English.
He learns English.
He learns English.
She learns English.
She learns English.
They learn English.
They learn English.
Are you able to get now what I'm trying to show? I'm trying to show you all the pronouns which we can use and also how in the present tense the verb is changing. Now, would you like to read all these? Like yesterday, read it loudly. I want to hear your pronunciations. Start.
Mangoes. We like mangoes. You like mangoes. He likes mangoes. She likes mangoes. They like mangoes. I go to college. We go to college. You go to college. He goes to college. She goes to college. They go to college.
Please stop here. The word is not college, it is college.
College.
Okay, short sound should come. Read that again. I go to college.
I go to college.
We go to college.
We go to college. Go to college. Go to college. They go to college. College.
Did you get the difference now? How you pronounced first time and now? This is how phonetics is learned. This is how pronunciation is learned. Not by learning separately, word by word. When you start pronouncing, the best way to look at pronunciation. You know, these days there are many animation movies. Have you seen? Small children's animated movies which have subtitle all in English. So you watch the animation movie, you keep the sound, and if the sound is in English, listen to the sound while reading subtitle. First time, meaning, like somebody asked yesterday. Second time, meaning plus language. After some time, start reading with it. The animation is for small children, but you are using it for learning English. How do you learn? By repeatedly seeing it 10 times, 20 times, till these words echoing in your mind with the correct pronunciation. That way, if you do, it is very good. There are many speeches of famous people on YouTube. You want to see any good speeches, you can go to YouTube and see famous people. Long back, they must have spoken. Swami Vivekananda's speech at the Chicago Parliament. If you want, the audio is there. Script is there. If you buy from Ramakrishna Math 5 rupee book, you will get the script. So look at the script, listen to it. See the pronunciation. Improve the pronunciation by reading along with it. When you hear something, you read along with it. Unless you do these exercises yourself, nobody can improve your English. If you depend on outside sources, then they will learn English. You are allowing me to speak today, 2 hours every day. So my English is becoming better. Your English is not improving because I am getting practice. You understand? Now read next column. Start.
I play cricket. We play cricket. You play cricket. He plays cricket. She plays cricket. They play cricket. I learn English. We learn English. You learn English. He learns English. She learns English. They learn English.
Now, when we use any noun, whether it is in the beginning of the sentence or end of sentence, no change comes. If I say this is a table, table is same. This table is black, that also is same. So table coming in the beginning, subject or end, table remains table, no problem. In pronouns, such a thing doesn't happen. I changes, when we change the position, the function, I becomes me, we becomes us, you remains the same, he becomes him, she becomes her, they becomes them. So you can see that by subject pronoun becoming object pronoun, the meaning is the same, but the word form is different. The word is different, meaning is same. That is why we make a lot of mistakes. Suppose it says, the boss wants to meet you and me. Why we are using me? The boss wants to meet object you and me. You and me have to go to the boss, wrong English. Because you and me became subject. So you say, you and I have to go to the boss. The boss wants you and me. You and I have to go to the boss. So the same person is saying me once, I once. The problem is that the function has changed. The meaning has not changed. That is why grammar is important. But please remember that the best way of learning grammar is to learn it from real life English. You know, they say live projects. I think software professionals. I don't know. Do they say we will do live project? Live project means this. In English, live project means you learn from English. You don't learn from a book. You know the story of that scholar who was going in a boat. He read many books on swimming, but he could not swim. Our grammar book is like that. We know lots of grammar. We know how to read English, write exams in English. We pass big exams, but our English does not improve. So we have to improve the language, the skill, the speaking and writing. We don't have to improve only grammar, only pronunciation, only spelling, or only vocabulary. Only these things, improvement is not enough. So again, you take these as sentences, these are like seeds, and make hundreds of sentences using the pronoun as I, subject, using the pronoun as me, object. Object comes at the end of the sentence, subject comes at the beginning of the sentence. All English sentences have a subject. Those verbs which are transitive verbs always have object. What is a transitive verb? Again, you do some Google search or you look at the presentations on grammar, you will learn details. But learning so much grammar, our mind becomes totally confused. Why we have to learn so much grammar? No need. Grammar are rules to help us to speak. If we can speak without learning grammar, that would be wonderful. I saw a group of children who were just about 2 years old. They were being taught English. Their mother tongue is not English. They were being taught English by making them see some computer programs. Small story the child is made to see, only 2 years old. The whole thing is in English. The child doesn't know one word of English. The child does not know alphabet A, B, C, D. Nothing. The child has not gone to school. This is preschool training in English. So after seeing that same video again and again and again, the child starts speaking English. You know, that is the natural way of learning. No need for a book. No need for learning in the way of learning. First A, B, C, D you learn. Then you read A for apple, books like that. That way if you learn, that is an artificial method of learning. So all of us should now think that we are going to learn English naturally. That natural process of learning is what I'm trying to tell you. I don't know whether I'm successful because nobody likes to practice. You know, whenever I tell anybody to practice, they say, okay, we'll do it later. In Hyderabad, we have a term, you know, in Nizam's time, when I was very young, they should always say, parso. I don't know today if that term is still used. Parso means infinity. We don't know, Usually the meaning is day after tomorrow. But it's not actually day after tomorrow. It is after 1 month, after 2 months, after 10 months. No limit. So we had this joke by saying, if you ask anybody to do any work, they will say, when will you do it? Parso. Actually, they will not do it day after tomorrow. They will do it sometime afterwards. So our practice is like that. We say we will practice, but we don't practice at all. Okay? So I'm insisting that whatever I'm reading for you is for you practice here. This practice is like small, you know, 0.0001%. You want to learn English, 100%. So if you are math students, you please count and see. If 0.001 is in the classroom, then how much percentage you have to do to get it into 100%. I don't know maths because I'm an English teacher. So I'm not calculating for you. You calculate and see how much you have to practice. Okay? Please read